Weird ultimate endorsement. I love the Big Sick. I think it's great. I've told everybody that a million times. My wife has seen it. She saw it with me once, went and saw it with a girlfriend second time. My mother-in-law has seen it three times.
Okay.
Here comes Kumail Nanjiani and his real-life wife, Emily V. Gordon. Let's forget about Silicon Valley.
Good morning.
Emily,
good morning.
I didn't know that you were on Celebrity All-Star Bowling with Chris Hardwick. What's bigger than that?
Yeah,
we
that's your
more.
Biggest credit so far.
Oh God, I guess.
Well,
it
we played the Walking Dead gang, which was pretty cool.
We got to bowl against the Walking Dead, which was pretty great.
Which is not fair because Steve Yeun is a total ringer. He's like amazing at it.
He's very good at bowling and many other things.
Yeah, it's not fair.
Kids, what is it like to be the toast of the town? And did you feel, I don't know, any sense in risk comes to mind? I mean, this is a wonderful movie, but it's a deeply personal movie.
Yeah, it's certainly something that we kind of talked about, but I don't think we were ready for the full extent of strangers asking me how my blood oxygen level is. I wasn't quite ready for that.
But it's all good.
It's been really lovely. Yeah, it's been a really wonderful experience, but one that I don't think anything can kind of prepare you for.
We weren't ready for it because we sort of made this movie and you have no idea how things are going to go or if anybody's ever going to see it. I mean, the movie's still got a long way to go. It's only just now going wide, but the reception so far has been so wonderful and overwhelming. There was this like older like Indian couple that was like, I finally understand the decisions that my son made.
Oh, you didn't tell me that?
Yeah, I didn't tell you that.
Oh, that's lovely.
This was in London and I was like, oh my God, that's such a beautiful thing to hear.
Ray Romano and Holly Hunter, you have this fabulous cast. Were you pleased and impressed that people were like, you know what? Yeah, we're in.
We were shocked. When Judd Apatow, it was his idea to cast both Ray Romano and Holly Hunter, and we were like, okay, good luck, buddy.
But he's Judd Apatow, he can do that.
He's literally Judd Apatow, he can do anything he wants. And the fact that they were both interested kind of floored us, and to even meet them was amazing, and to have them kind of in a movie saying lines that we'd written was mind-blowing.
Working with them was, for me, you know, it was such a thrill and such a learning experience too, to see how these two legends approach their craft. I'm so sorry.
Legends approach their craft.
I know.
What a great line.
I'm getting all, that's my Netflix series coming out. It's just overwhelming. I don't know what to say. It's very emotional. It just gets me like going thinking about it.
With good reason. Now, here's the thing. Come on, you're a performer. We've seen you in front of the camera a lot. Emily, did you want to play yourself, or did you feel an actress should play me in the movie?
She messed up the audition.
I wasn't good in the audition. No. I tried so hard, guys. I'm just not an actress, and I love writing, and I really wanted this movie to be good, and I was like, if I'm in this movie, I could tank this whole thing. So I thought it would be best left to professionals. Kumail's been acting for quite some time. I haven't acted since high school, so I was very happy. I was really good in high school, though.
Were you?
I was the president of the Thespian Society in high school.
Right.
But I was thought it
and
best.
This was at, where was this, Yale?
Not at Yale.
Yale is not a high school.
To turn it over to professionals, and Zoe Kazan did such a great job. If you have to have someone play you in a movie, let it be Zoe Kazan.
Really, really good job. I always think sometimes there's this particular point of demarcation. Movie's been done, you made it. Maybe this was Sundance, maybe it was somewhere else, where you thought, you know what? People are really into and enjoying this movie.
I would say Sundance was the first time.
I still haven't processed.
No, but Sundance was when I was like, I was like, oh, okay, it seems like people like this movie.
Yeah, I definitely, especially as a writer, I don't get recognized. And Sundance was the most famous I think I'll ever be. and that was kind of a jarring experience to go from, you know, being a writer to kind of having people like walk over to me when I walk into a room and try to take photos of me. That was quite strange.
It's also strange because it's like nobody's seen your movie, and then 24 hours later, 5,000 people in this tiny town at Sundance have seen the movie. So that was like a very like quick whirlwind kind of where we went from like just this thing that we had to like this thing suddenly that this whole town knew about.
Well, it's going to be a lot bigger than that. Kids, they're rushing you along. Good Morning Kalamazoo awaits. So we'll let you guys go. Really nice to speak with you. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
You can just see how jazzed they are with each other.
I know. Yeah.
Isn't that great?
They were delightful.
Very delightful.
So it's about their story meeting as a couple and what she dealt with.
Right. It's really just this love story. It is fantastic. Many more theaters on Friday.
The fact that your mother-in-law saw it three times. That's what sold me.
It's awfully good. And then what's funny, having never met Emily before, Zoe Kazan, who plays her, got her. Really gets the essence of her. It's a great, great movie. Wow. That was fun.